I am Gabriel. I'm a PhD student in forest technology with industrial planting. Today I am going to talk about the use AI for modeling edible mushroom yields. Mushrooms are one of the most prized non-wood forest products. They are also part of numerous ecosystem services, such as mushroom shopping, cultural, regulating, and support service, because they are key organisms in the ecosystem functioning. Their feeding bodies, the mushrooms, have medicinal, commercial, nutritional, and recreational importance. No way, mushroom picking is a booming activity among people all over Europe. Locals collect mushrooms every autumn and also every spring for their own consumption or to generate supplementary incomes, either by direct scale or by tourist exploitation. But mushroom exploitation is limited by the fact that mushrooms present a high irregularity in their harvest, to which is added the effect to climate change, which causes the fruiting of mushrooms to be increasingly scarce, especially in Mediterranean environment, as it was stated by Teresa Obreda and colleagues. Many facts are related to triggering of mushroom development, and most of them are affected by climate change. The most important variables that are key factors in mushroom formation, as compiled in the review done by Tomau and collaborators, has been known for a long time ago. In fact, we all know when and where to go to pick a mushroom. Site-specific variables, soil characteristics, topographic characteristics, and climatic variables, and structural variables, footprint and land area cover, tree species composition, and age of the species. Mushroom yields have a large interannual and intra-annual variability. To overcome this problem, AI can help us. With AI, we can process a large amount of in situ data. Therefore, AI tools open to a way to introduce mushroom production patients into system and forest management tools. And all my objective of this work is to estimate to a mycological possibility of Lactarius deliciosus in a Pinus pinaster forest. We all want to know whether or not there will be mushrooms this year. For this proposed, Lactarius deliciosus collection data from 18 plots located in the province of Soria, central Spain, were used. The plots are located in a pine forest of Pinus pinaster, strategically placed by age classes. Mushrooms are collected since 1997 up to the present day, during the fruiting session, from September to December. Every week, these Lactarius were weighted and counted. As a climatic data, we focus on temperature and rain, as they are key in triggering fungi certificate. Using monthly average temperature, monthly maximum temperature, monthly minimum temperature, monthly precipitation, and relative humidity since 1997. These data are collected from the Agencia Estatal de Meteorología. When calculating LIDAR variables, we need field data, so we measure all the diameters and height of the trees that the within the plot are processed and penalized of the area. We calculated number of teeth, bathymetric area, site index, height, and hardworking index. For the remotely sensitive data, we use seasonal imaging from the Landsat missions since 1997. This image has a spatial resolution of 30 meters. We calculate the following indices for the four seasons of the year. And normalized difference vegetation index, green normalized difference vegetation index, soil adjusted vegetation index, enhanced vegetation index, and normalized difference moisture index. We use the index of the current and previous years. As in the work of Olano and colleagues, it was found that NDVI is a good estimation of primary productivity, and it was found that the primary productivity of the previous years had a strong correlation with the lactarious years. These examples show the seasonal NDVI images of 1 year. With all the data collected, we made 5 classification models. These models are neural networks, support vector matching radial, support vector matching linear, classification trees, and random forests. And the results were, the best classification model was the neural network model, and the most important variables were September maximum temperature, November minimum temperature, summer previous summer GNDVI, number of trees. And thanks to AI, it allows us to arrive at more accurate predictions for mass procurement. AI helped us in sustainable forest management of no good forest credit. Thus, AI is currently of great help for forest management, forest resource management, and ecosystem service management. And thanks for your attention.